Welcome. This is a pretty short informal tutorial, but I wanted to talk about how to do some basic recolors for your VRChat avatar. I was asked this question a couple of times in various Discord servers, since a lot of people are totally happy with base models, but just want to recolor them or add logos, edit textures, etc. There are a lot of highly involved, precise ways you can do this using tools such as the Blender Node Editor. However, I'm just going to talk about Photoshop, PhotoPea, any photo editing software that you can get your hands on. You can follow this tutorial. So the model I'm going to showcase this on today is actually available on my store. Her name is Rin. She's got a whale shark plushie and all sorts of really awesome features. It would mean a lot if you could go check her out. That aside, let's say we want to edit the color of her shorts, right? So if I select whatever I want to edit and hit slash, it allows me to isolate it, which is super helpful if your avatar has a lot of meshes or props and or is complicated and you just need to focus on one little thing. Hitting slash again unhides it, and hitting slash again rehides it, and so forth. Although it's fairly obvious looking at this texture which part of it is the shorts, if you have something a little bit more complicated, you may need to locate which part you actually want to recolor or edit. We can figure out what part of our texture corresponds to what part of our 3D model using the UV editing tab. Hit tab to enter edit mode and hit L to select linked objects. In the UV editing window, you'll notice what are called UV islands appear over our texture. These islands are the flattened versions of our mesh over here. We can use our knowledge of the locations of these islands to know what to edit when we enter our texture editing software. If you're not seeing all of the islands pop up or not all of your mesh is selecting, you may need to change the limiting method of your selection. When we select linked earlier, we select what was linked by normal, or what vertices were connected. We can also select what's linked by material or by UV seam, allowing us to isolate certain parts of our mesh. So in the case of this avatar, it's very obvious what texture we're looking to edit, since all of the clothes are neatly atlased onto one texture. However, for some avatar setups, it's not entirely obvious what texture you should be editing, or you may want to make a backup and not edit the original texture. In that case, you can look at the top of the UV editing window for your texture name, right here. And additionally, you can click Image and Save As or Save As a Copy in order to make an additional copy of your image. I'm going to keep this setup in Blender open in the background while I work on editing textures so I can use it for reference. I've opened the texture that I plan to edit in Photoshop. Please keep in mind you can use any image editing software besides just Photoshop. For example, GIMP, Fire Alpaca, Procreate, Clip Studio, Paint, etc. If you don't have access to Photoshop and you're not sure which tool to use, I would highly recommend PhotoPea. PhotoPea is a free online photo editor that has most, if not all, of the features of Photoshop. Most importantly, you can use all Photoshop keybinds within PhotoPea, meaning that you get the most similar experience to Photoshop for free. For this part of the tutorial, I'll be working in Photoshop, but I'll have a small window in the corner that shows how you would do it in PhotoPea as well at the same time. So based on what we found out in the Blender UV editor, we need to edit these three islands in color. In Photoshop, first we need to select the islands. You have a variety of selection tools at your disposal. Keep in mind, some may work better for some texture sets than others. A lot of these automatic selection tools are based on contrast ratios, so if you have a lot of similarly colored or similarly valued, meaning similar in light to dark, it may not work accurately for your model. The four tools I recommend that you try are the Object Selection Tool, Quick Selection Tool, Magic Wand Tool, and Polygonal Lasso. I'm going to start by using the Quick Selection Tool to select as much as I can, and then follow up with the Lasso Tool to clean up edges that may have made mistakes. So I'm just going to click and drag, and there's the first part of my selection. If I want to select more while I already have some selected, I'm going to hold down Shift and continue clicking and dragging. So I did a pretty okay job with these islands, but you'll notice I accidentally selected a little bit too much right here. I'm going to Control or Command Plus to zoom in on them. You can also Control Minus to zoom out, and switch over to the Lasso tool. I'm going to hit Alt instead of Shift to subtract stuff from my selection. So I want to just remove what I've accidentally overselected here. I'm just kind of eyeballing it. There we go, and that's a little bit more of an accurate selection. I'm going to use the Hand tool, H, to pan over to what else I need to select. And I'm going to go back to using the Lasso tool, just since it's a simple rectangle, and hold Shift and click to add this to our selection as well. now that I have everything that I want to edit selected, I'm going to Control J. Control J creates a duplicate of what you've selected as a new layer. That way we can edit just this while still having the original underneath it intact. With our new layer selected, I'm going to hit Control U to pull up our hue and saturation sliders. Additionally, you can go under Image, Adjustments, Hue Saturation. Now I can very easily drag the slider in order to make some really quick changes to our model. When I have a color that I like, I'm going to hit OK. You can also use this time to add any text, drawings, or logos onto your avatar. For example, if I wanted to put my name on the waistband, I could type it in using the text tool and position it where I wanted it. Now that I have my example image all edited and ready to put on my avatar, it's time to export it from Photoshop. You can use either Export, Quick Export as PNG, or Export As, and choose PNG. If I know my texture doesn't use any transparency at all, I usually uncheck transparency to make my file size smaller. If you're not sure or you know that your file uses transparency, leave transparency checked. Now all I have to do is click Export and choose the location on my computer that I want to save it at. In order to use the new texture on your avatar, you'll need to import it in Unity and replace your old texture with the new one. I will not be covering that in this video, but I've linked a couple of different videos of popular shader creators showing how to do it with their shader that you can follow along with. However, I will show you how to quickly preview your texture in Blender. I highly recommend this step because it lets you see if you have any issues or errors with your edited texture before you set everything up in Unity. Since we don't need the UV editing tools anymore, I'm going to go back to the default tab, make sure that I have our mesh selected, and look for the materials icon over here. In our material properties, I'm simply going to replace our old texture with our new texture using this file folder icon right here. This is an example of why we need to preview our textures before we import them into Unity. You'll notice that some of my logos is upside down and some of my text is stretched, so I'm quickly going to go and make the changes in Photoshop and then re-import and retest my texture. So as you can see, I've made some really quick tweaks to the texture and I like how it looks much better now. Now I'm all good to take my texture, import it into Unity, and update my avatar. Thank you so much for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. I hope you found it helpful. If you liked the avatar that I showcased in this video, I actually made her. You can find her on my booth page now for about $20. It would mean a lot if you could check her out. She's got all sorts of features. I worked super hard on her. Other than that, I make all this content for free. You can support me by liking, subscribing, leaving a comment if you have any questions. I try to get to every single one. Thank you so much for all of your support so far. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. See you in the next one.